And I think the problem that we're now facing in limiting the ability for that to happen, and luckily when I was in like public school, it really wasn't a thing, was the censorship and challenging of books and history in school. I feel really lucky to, you know, be in college now and to be at a private institution where these things are just not simply, they're not up for debate, but they exist in a really serious way in our public classrooms. And what do you make of these efforts? And what do you think that books, you know, how do books play a role in these social justice movements of today?
You know, the thing that is really, really interesting to me about the publishing industry right now, and especially what kinds of books are coming out in children's literature in the last just few years, last, you know, even 10 years or so, it is kind of spectacular, the kind of literature that's coming out of children's literature publishing. And it really kind of surprises me that the idea of censoring books is taking so much traction. And it's being paired with this idea of, you know, books that are older being better written or better literature or things like that, when the writing is just getting stronger and stronger, the forms, the structures of stories are just getting more complex and more interesting. So that particular argument that the books are not as good doesn't actually hold, because the literature
it never has.
It's true, but it's like, it is really particularly egregious right now, because the kind of writing that's coming out of children's literature right now is amazing. I am consistently amazed at the writing that comes out. And you realize very starkly, and it was always the case, which I know you know, it was always the case that this is about holding down certain groups of people. This is about racism. It's about misogyny. It is about anti-LGBTQIA+. It really is just about holding power for people who have had power and who do not want to give up power. That's really what censorship is about. It is about nothing else. It is not about the literature. It is not about the strength of the writing. It is not even about the content of the writing, where they keep trying to say it's about the content of the writing. The content of the writing is actually amazing. It is actually stuff that kids want to read. And it is actually presented in a way that is really appropriate for the age level. Like, these are things that authors and editors are constantly talking about, like, is it appropriate? Is it, and there are so many experts that we can go to talk to about this. Like, I have a degree in education, so I really know like what's appropriate. But I have never come across any book that is coming out for kids that has really inappropriate content. It is, you know, so the argument is specious. It just does not hold. And it really is just about power. And I think that most people do understand that. The important thing, though, is that we need to push back against it as much as we can every single time. Like, don't even give it a single moment. Never give it a chance to get its little hooks in, because the moment it does, then, you know, it just becomes a bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger thing. So we are always pushing against it. And there's so many authors and so many publishers who are really starting to, who have always been pushing against this, so that, you know, people understand that censorship is not okay. It is never okay. It is just, it should not be a thing. Like, why are you doing this? You know, the idea of freedom means freedom. It's being free to have access to things. That is what freedom means. It does not mean its opposite.
I completely agree with you. And I find this moment very difficult in a way that, like, this is just not the trajectory I thought we were on. You know, like, this is just really not what I thought was going to happen. But it is the everyday investments of people that believe in these stories, that respect and honor history, and that believe in my generation and generations to come, that, you know, make learning possible, that make storytelling possible. And you are one of those people. So we want to thank you so much for your time. Everybody go out there and make a reading connection with Because Claudette. It is an amazing story that tells us about civil rights narratives that we often don't get to hear, and also celebrates Black girls and the power of Black girls. So thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Thank you so much, Marley.